Climate change is not new. Just in the last 650,000 years, there has been 7 cycles of glacial advance and retreat. Today, our planet is once again undergoing changes, but in some places, they are striking faster than in others. One of those places is in Antarctica. In Antarctica, the local fauna survived glaciations in the past by migrating in so-called refugia, such as the deep sea and ice-free areas.
Confronted with sudden environmental changes, organisms in Antarctic ecosystems are challenged once again. In fact, they face 3 possible outcomes: migration, adaptation, or extinction. Our research project focuses on 6 Antarctic animal groups based on their position in the food web: birds, fish, bivalves, echinoderms, amphipods, and ostracods. We investigate how their ancestors reacted to past climate change events and how variations in the environment today influence their behavior. Let's take a look at 2 of the most striking examples. One of them is a top predator. This is the snow petrel, a little seabird which is found all around the Antarctic. Conservation biologist Henri Roubert went looking for them during an expedition on the Soar Rondon Mountains. Snow petrels breed on lunar tucks in little holes. Henri went looking for them on these ice-free rocky slopes. He recorded the location of every nest and sampled feathers and carcasses without disturbing the birds. These samples will be used for DNA analysis later to reconstruct the evolutionary history. Our second guest is a group of animals called amphipods. Amphipods are small crustaceans. They are very diverse and they are found in many different habitats. These tiny shrimps are organisms that are good study objects because they are vulnerable to environmental changes and they have a key position in the Antarctic food web. You mess with them, you mess with the whole ecosystem. We studied 2 groups of amphipods located at 2 different places, one in the West Antarctic Peninsula and one in Adelieland. The very different environmental conditions in these 2 zones clearly influence amphipod ecology. The West Antarctic Peninsula is the zone where impacts of global change are the strongest, and we observed that the amphipods living in this area need more food to survive. If things get worse, environmental changes in this region might reinforce these trends. This could lead to more competition and perturb the amphipod communities. So, by studying how 6 Antarctic animal groups react to climate change, we try to better understand how they migrated in the past, what adaptations against the harsh climate they have developed, and how we could prevent their extinction. Study the past if you would define the future, as Confucius so wisely said.